Uganda is disadvantaged in science, technology, and innovation efforts due to low investment in SDI capacity development. But this is going to change because the government is rolling out several initiatives to support young innovators and scientists. Tonight, we sit down with Dr. Monica Musenero from the Secretariat of Science, Technology, and Innovation to understand all the opportunities up for grabs.
Science, technology, and innovation is a very key driver to national development. And it has been proved that 50% of any nation's development is hinged on how they leverage science, technology, and innovation. So if a country does not effectively adopt science, technology, and innovation, then even at the very best, their sectors will perform below 50%, because the only factor that differentiates countries, the poor and underdeveloped countries, from the prosperous and developed countries, is how they have leveraged science, technology, and innovation. So it is key, actually it is central. When a country is at the first levels, you can apply borrowed knowledge, even traditional knowledge, but for any nation now to shift and develop and provide the essentials of life, the technology that enables their population to live, you must effectively adopt science, technology, and innovation. However, many African nations, Uganda inclusive, it took us long to understand how this works. And so much as we have invested a lot, we have actually invested a lot, especially the NRM government. It has invested a lot in building national capacity to leverage. And we understood that science is, people go and study science at primary school, at secondary school, at university, and we do some TVET, some vocational skills. We train people up to PhD level. But how does it exactly connect to the economy? Yes, to impact on their lives, to create jobs, to enable the country to sell better value. As globally, you see things evolve. We didn't have cars in the 18th century, 19th century. We had cars, now we have very big cars. Right now, you can fly for 13, 14, 15 hours in space. But if you do, your nation does not understand how to engage science technology to be a productive science, to be a productive commodity in your nation, in your economy, then you remain behind as underdeveloped and poor. The differentiation between developed nations and underdeveloped nations is basically a reference to how they have utilized the science, technology, and innovation. And now in Uganda, over the past 2.5 years, we have brought together all the efforts that have been made by government and interpreted them, contextualized them, and created what we call the STI Economy Highway. And that is a guidance that helps us to understand. It has 5 major milestones. The first is science. Having individuals that understand the basics of science, that appreciate science. Because, you know, when there is no science, there is myths. And everything, every death is caused by an enemy or by a spirit, every illness. So, but when you understand the principles of nature, which is really what science is, understanding how nature works, that's the knowledge. Then we have to convert that knowledge into tools or technology. And once we have done and converted that knowledge into technology, then we have to convert it into innovations. Innovations is when you apply the principles of science and develop the tools to address specific problems. For example, on Independence Day, we launched a small car, a farm vehicle called Bingwa. Now, we had to understand the science of how engines work, how fuel works, how motion works as science. We used it to develop technology, develop an engine. But then how does it solve the problems of man, the problems in the country? How does it address issues of poverty and underdevelopment? So we come up with this farm vehicle, which is supposed to help us solve problems which are practical. Now that's innovation. However, just having science, technology, and innovation stop there does not impact on the economy of a country. The innovations must result in industries. Industrialization is so key to any national development because it is what brings what's known as socio-economic transformation, moving your population from working from subsistence agriculture, and just basically what the president commonly calls in Kolerachida, where people are just surviving. When you move your population now to work in value-added jobs, because you've created that value. So industrialization is very, very important. But just creating industries is not enough. You must market. And that's the commercialization. So that highway has 5 milestones. The science milestone, technology milestone, innovation milestone, industrialization, and commercialization. And that is how science will then lead to transformation of a nation.
Welcome to the National Science Week, Uganda.
This event used to be there. It was started by the then National Council of Science and Technology, but it was a very low-key event. By 2020, when I became presidential advisor on epidemics, it had remained as a day because 10th November is the World Science Day for Peace and Development. So it's an international day. So they had given up celebrating the week. So we established the National Science Week as a hallmark event in the nation, on the national calendar, to help Ugandans to come together to see where they are, but also to identify opportunities and also responsibilities. So it's our biggest event in the calendar of science, and hopefully as we move ahead, it will become the biggest event in the national calendar in terms of looking at our development. We have demystified innovation. Innovators range from those who have never been to school to those who are highly educated. So the National Science Week is a mixing pot. It's a meeting place. During the National Science Week, I shift my office from here. I locate the office at the Kororo, and we interact with innovators. Our one-stop center for innovators to come, those we don't know anything about. So there is the interaction and getting to know and answering their questions, but also registering them, capturing them. The other way is to provide visibility for innovators that we already have. Many of them have products, and some of the products are really good, but they need the investment, they need partnerships for them to move forward. So then we are also training them. We are preparing quite a number. We have what we call the investor readiness program. So if there are people with innovations out there and you think your innovation is really good, it has reached that point where you think you need innovation, even if you're not sure, you come, we'll interact with you. So from now up to Science Week, we prepare the innovators to do the pitch, to present to investors about investment, because you know innovation and investment go hand in hand. But also this year, we're going to have what we call Made in Uganda Supermarket. Yes, Made in Uganda Supermarket. Innovation is not complete until there's a product that a minimum number of clients are willing to pay for at a particular price, which gives a return on the investment by the innovator and the investors. So no matter how much you invest, if you don't push the last pillar, the last milestone in the highway, which is the trade, the commercialization, then innovation will not take off. So during this year's Science Week, we are going to be launching the Made in Uganda supermarket. We are launching it because it is going to continue. We shall communicate, of course, to relocate from Kororo after that week, but we are going to set up actually both a physical place and an online market where it's a platform for our innovators to avail their products to the market.